Have you ever been scrolling down social media and you saw this picture that made you stop scrolling and you scrolled back up and to see the picture again and you look at it, it is a normal picture but for some reason it grabbed your attention? Guess what? This particular trick I'm going to show you today is going to make people stop while scrolling social media just to look at your pictures. Watch till the end. Yo, what's up, Dynamite? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to color grade for great impact. Before we dive into this tutorial, please take a minute, subscribe to this channel. Let me give you a moment. Done? Let's dive into this. The strategy we are going to use is we're just going to play around with colors that are opposite one another. Let me explain to you. We're going to use what they call a color wheel. So what you're going to do, you're going to come here, open up any browser, whatever browser you use, and then you come into Google and put in the word color wheel. Yep. Okay. So you come and download this image. Yeah, of course, for me, I've already downloaded mine, but you download that image. And I'm just going to show you exactly what I mean when we talk about making colors. Basically, we make colors that are opposite one another stand out. Let me just open this image here and I'll just pull it here and see. Now, when you look at this image, the colors that are opposite one another are the colors that we make vibrant. For example, if our image had a purple, or is this purple? Okay, a purple background. We would make the purple vibrant and the yellows in the pictures vibrant. And we somehow desaturate the other colors within the image. Now, in this particular image, we have the cyans, which is around this zone. And we have the skin tones and these oranges, which are around this area. So we're going to make these particular colors pop so that they all fight for presence within this particular image. That is how you make certain images, certain parts of your pictures pop and leave the other ones silent. It is that contrast and the fight between colors that creates that pop in an image. Let me show you how we are applying this. So this is an image, of course, of a friend of mine called Rita, one of the models I use the most. We've not done any skin retouching, not anything to do with this, but I'm just only going to show you how to do color corrections. So what are we going to do here? Let me just close these tabs here. So we're going to come here into adjustment layers. If you don't have the layers panel here, you just come into Windows and you say, you click onto this particular layers, this will come. So you come into adjustment layers here, and then you say selective color. So the first thing we are going to do, we are first going to work on the cyans within this particular image. We're going to make sure that we suck out all the reds that are all the magentas and the reds that are in these cyans. So what do? You come into the cyan zone, and then you just increase the cyan. You just move it forward just like that. See, let me just zoom this out so that you see the effect better. You know, I just come and zoom it E and actually push it that way up to around 60. Then I just come pull out the magenta and put the magenta within that particular zone in the negatives so that we lose out on the reds completely so that it gets towards the green. Then we're going to come and make the yellows a little bit, pull out the yellows also just a little bit so that we don't have any of the oranges come into this color. So the next thing we're going to do, we are going to name this cyans. Okay, we are naming those cyans. So now we're going to work on the skin tones. Okay, so the skin tones, we just come here and say selective color. The skin tones are what color could you think are the skin tones? Yes, you guessed right. They are in the reds. So you come here in the reds, right there. And then you come and we say, okay, now we want to pull out the cyans from the reds. So what do? We just get onto the cyan thing and then we just pull it back. See, let me just take it overboard so that you see how it is going to, how the face is going to pop over that background. See, when we take it overboard, see how the face pops, but we don't want to take it overboard. We just want to take it, to keep it a bit subtle, a bit, you know, a very, very tiny adjustment. Then we are going to come and make the magentas, slightly we drive them forward so that we emphasize the reds even more. And we are also going to bring the yellows slightly up front, just like that. So see, now these are, we're going to name these skin tones. So which color, which other color are we going to make pop that is slightly towards the opposite of these zones? I think you guessed right. It is the yellows, the oranges in the yellows. So how do we do that? We still come here in this adjustment layers, we say selective color, and then you come here and say yellows. Now for the yellows, of course, we are going to remove the cyans. So we don't want the yellows to look that, like the way they look. We are just going to take it towards this side, and we make the hair shine a bit and give that hair. I'm going to take this overboard since it's not on skin, it's not on hair, it's not on rather a very delicate part. Since it's on hair, I'll just take the piece and make it overboard. Of course, the cyans, I'll just have to bring them in and enhance the yellows even more within this particular thing. And I'll come and close this. So I'm going to name this hair. Really, this is, you don't have to do it for, because you may find some people having black hair, other people, but look at the main features within the whole composition to help you define which parts you want to pop and which parts you want to silence in an image. So what do we do in order to remove these reds that have come into the face? So you come select this this hair layer, and then you get your brush tool. This is the brush tool. Make sure black is on top. Yeah, and then you come and paint over. Let's put the opacity also at 100, and then you come and just paint over. Let me just zoom it in so that you get an actual feel of what I'm talking about. You come get your brush and then just paint over so that you get those yellows that are, you know, contaminating the rest of the skin out of just rubbing. And now we have another challenge. When you look at this particular piece, we also have cyans that came into this particular dirty white in this ivory top. So what are we going to do? You just come here, right here in the cyan zone, and still get your brush, and then you just rub the cyan off the white, just like this. Like, see, now let me just put these in a group and I show you guys the before and after. You're going to be super amazed. Look at this. That's the before and that is the after. Guys, this is so amazing. Look at this. That's the before and that's the after. What if we want to take it, to exaggerate it a bit further? Can we do that? Yes, definitely we can do that. Now, I want to make this cyan in the background even pop more. So what do we do? I just come here and then get the hue saturation layer and get this hand here, click on it, and then right here, and then click onto the cyan and then drive it forward, just taking it forward so that I make those cyans pop. Don't take it overboard for it to get exaggerated. No, we just want to move it slightly, just a little bit, like that, for us to give that particular thing a pop. And guys, there you have it. See how you make color grading that has impact? This is how they do it, man. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, of course, click the first link in the description below. I would be super grateful. Oh, if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, give this video a thumbs up, leave comments below, tell me what you think, and I'll see you in my next tutorial. And adios.